As I said in my comments a few minutes before, interbody cage and graft and osteotomy are two main surgical techniques for deformity correction in the adults. We must have three concerns in surgical planning. One is the sagittal balance. You have heard already a good talk on it. The other one is the degree of osteoporosis. If the bone is very osteoporotic, you must take some cautions against this. And the premorbid diseases. If the patient is has a severe cardiac disease with insufficiency, for instance, then you cannot bleed too much. Normal aging is being kyphotic. Can we return it back? Actually, normally all persons become getting some weight loss and then become kyphotic. So recent trend is to correct this. But then we have problems like osteoporosis, more deformity, and more comorbidities. How can we deal with them? If we talk about degenerative deformity, we are talking mostly for flat back syndrome. Dr. Echo has shown us very nice cases about that. The other one is the degenerative scoliosis. Degenerative scoliosis is quite different than adolescent scoliosis. Because in adolescence, there is no pain at all because of scoliosis. It is flexible and there is no neurology. However, in adult deformities, in adult degenerative scoliosis, it is a rigid deformity and the patients are mostly coming to surgeons with significant pain and neurological symptoms. It's a geriatric population. There's additional rotation. Apex is mostly L2 and L3. And there are additional spondylolisthesis or lateral spondylolisthesis or loss of lordosis. I mean, coronal and sagittal imbalance are together. I want to remind you the phases of degeneration. Actually, we know that there is first a dysfunctional phase, which simple back pain starts. Sometimes you can even see some black discs on the MR images. Then an unstable phase. There may be degenerative listhesis or some deformities. And then a rest stabilization phase comes. So our surgeries must be tailored according to those phases. And difficulty is sometimes in one patient, in one level, it is an unstable phase, the other level is rest stabilization phase. So it's quite complex because of that. Probably we can also call a terminology, the complex lumbar spinal stenosis for the patients having additional degenerative scoliosis, previous lumbar spine surgery, radiological instability and degenerative listhesis. Long fixation is if your fixation level is going up to L2, it is a long fixation. So long fixations are always open to long-term complications because of implants. There is no objections for short fixations. However, in long fixation, upper and lower spine must be stable and neutral. we must not end at thoracolumbar junction or apex of kyphosis. And we must try to stop at L5, and we must try not to involve sacrum to fixation if possible, because it's another junctional level, lumbosacral junction. And if we add a fixation at this level, the non-union rate is quite high. There are some indications I have written here about the when to add L5S1 to fixation. Osteoporosis is another problem at these ages. Some authors claim that if bone mineral density is less than 90 milligram per cubic centimeter, instrumentation is contraindicated. This is not probably true, but actually we must then prepare some measures against this. Instead, in case of osteoporosis, we can use larger diameter screws and longer screws with bicortical purchase. Use more fixation points. Do not use forceful correction maneuvers, and use cement to augment the bone around screw. This is one example that I have used to prevent, especially proximal junctional kyphosis. I have placed two additional levels vertebroplasty and cement around the screws. You can make with different techniques. There are cannulated screws. There are you can inject cement around the screws and others. So what are the complications of deformity correction in aged population? Adjust segment disease is one of them. Instrument failure, screw loosening and breakage is another one. It's quite common. And pseudoarthrosis, especially at L5S1 level. And because of these complications, the complication rate has been reported around 50%. If we are trying to correct a 75 years old or 80 years old person, the significant kyphosis, then we shall tell him or her that 50% complication rate is expected. Pseudoarthrosis rate is between 7 and 41. And reoperation rate is about 36%. It means one out of three of patients will need another surgery in the future. So I will not mention this, can skip, but if your fixation is very rigid, then the body distribute its loads to other segments, and then sacrum may get fractured, or sacroiliac joint problem may happen, even pelvis may get fractured. These are so-called sacral insufficiency fractures. How can we avoid those problems? We can first decide the aim of our surgery. If it is just one leg radiculopathy, then we can make just a simple decompression at that level. If our aim is deformity correction, what type of deformity correction must we do? We must decide it. Prophylactic surgeries may not be very feasible in most of the instances. And we must discuss all of these with the patient. Biomechanical analysis is very important. Actually, probably you get confused with too many measurements, iliac measurements or sacral incidence, some other things, but they are important. Dynamic films you must look at the dynamic films in spine and in standing position. On the left it is on spine, on the right it is on standing. Sagittal balance is quite important. And if you don't achieve good balance after surgery, you will expect more late-term problems like proximal junctional kyphosis or pseudoarthrosis, other things. These are some examples. This is one of the cases that the surgeon wanted to stop at the apex of the kyphosis, first surgery, but then it increased by the time the lateral stages, and then did a second surgery to lengthen it, passing the scoliotic level. This is another patient with fixation failure, junctional kyphosis, and the surgeon has lengthened the fixation till T11. Another case who had a previous surgery for 5 levels, and then it developed 2 months later with L2 compression, proximal junctional kyphosis, pain recurrence, and 3 months later, another surgery, but another proximal junctional kyphosis. Then the surgeon has gone till T9, but again another. So the surgeon has gone till T3. So this is an adventure with lumbar degenerative scoliosis. You can see the first film, then first revision, second revision, and third revision. Many, many revisions. I said before, we must try to avoid L5-S1 level. If there is, however, severe degenerative disc at L5-S1, or spondylolisthesis at L5, or severe lumbosacral slope, or previous decompressive surgery, we must add L5-S1 level. Sometimes we cannot say it is enough. We can add also a iliac screw to strengthen the level. Premorbid diseases, as I said before, are also very important in our decision making. Our aim must be to diminish the problem at the most painful area, not to correct one of the studies with the deformity correction with osteotomy, they have declared total major complications is 42%. Major complications, I'm telling you. The risk are if the age is more than 60 years, if there are 2 osteotomies, if it is a thoracic osteotomy. Thoracic osteotomy, because the spinal cord is there, is more risky. And this is a study comparing sacrum to upper thoracic and sacrum to lower thoracic fixation in sagittal imbalance. So they have found no difference. In general saying, degenerative lumbar deformity is a difficult form of deformity. It's a geriatric surgery. Is associated with mostly lumbar spine stenosis, osteoporosis, premorbid diseases, and high complication rates. And major complication rate is about 50%. And the reoperation rate is about 1 out of 3. We must first decide the aim of the surgery, and we must have such measures. We must look at all the parameters we will apply. And geriatric spine surgery is possible with good patient selection and good planning. There are mainly two surgical techniques to correct geriatric deformities: interbody cage and graft, or osteotomy. And we must have three concerns: sagittal balance, degree of osteoporosis, and premorbid diseases. Thank you for listening to me, and I want to invite you to Istanbul Spine Masters in April 2-3. We have those very distinguished speakers: Edward Benzel, Richard Fessler, Richard Asiker, Steinmetz, Strauss, Gitter, and also Salman Sharif. Salman Sharif will be with us. And there is one full endoscopy course with water irrigation system. I also want to invite you to Milan, Italy this year in June. Thank you.